order of succession, amount of successional rights, intrinsic validity of testamentary provisions, and under Article 1039, capacity to succeed. Regardless of what the testator may say in his will. Halimbawa, testator ay Hapon, tagal na dito, o Koreano. Okay? Isang katutak ng Koreano dito ngayon sa Pilipinas. Ang dami ng mga nag-settle down dito. Pati doon sa Pinoy Big Brother. Di ba? Daming mga Koreans doon. Okay. Kala rin nyo kayo lang nanonood noon. Okay. Sabi nung Korean na testator, I want my estate to be distributed in accordance with Philippine laws. Intrinsic validity, order of succession, all of this will be governed by Philippine laws. Kahit ano sabihin niya, hindi pa rin. Okay? It will still be Korean law, which will govern the four aspects of succession. I repeat, order of succession, amount of successional rights, intrinsic validity of testamentary provisions, and capacity to succeed. Let's now talk about witnesses to wills. Okay. What are the qualifications for witnesses? Okay, of course, sound mind. Okay. 18 years of age or more. Able to read and write. Not blind, deaf, or dumb. Domiciled in the Philippines and must not have been previously convicted of falsification, perjury, or false testimony. Remember the provisions of Article 823. Okay. If there is, according to Article 823, if there is a legacy or device in a will given to one of the witnesses to that will or given to his parent or spouse or child, that legacy or device is considered void insofar as that witness, his spouse, his parent, child, or anyone claiming under them is concerned. Unless there are three other witnesses, there are three other competent witnesses to the execution of the will. If A, B, and C are the witnesses to the execution of the will of Mr. X, and in that will, Mr. X gave one of them, Mr. A, one of the witnesses, a legacy of 50 million pesos. The will is valid. The validity of the will is not affected. A remains a qualified witness. Pero sorry na lang siya. He will not be able to get that legacy, even assuming that the estate has sufficient assets. Because under Article 823, that legacy is considered void. Okay? The obvious purpose here is to remove any temptation on the part of witnesses who might have been given something under the will to testify falsely. Can you just imagine what would happen? Alimbawa, tatlo ang testigo, A, B, and C. Let's assume that we did not have Article 823. And A, one of the three witnesses, has been given a legacy of 50 million pesos. Okay? Kahit na magluluhod siya sa Quiapo ng 10 taon, hindi niya makukuha yung 50 million na yan. 50 million is 50 million by any mathematics. Now, he is now on the witness stand. Namatay na ang testator, maraming assets. And he is being asked the critical question. Oh, Mr. Witness, where were you in relation to the testator when the testator was signing the will? Naalala ni A. nandun siya sa loob ng comfort room while the testator was signing the will. Because right before the testator started to sign, nakaramdam si A ng very urgent call of Mother Nature. So he had to rush to the comfort room. And while the testator was signing the will and all the pages thereof, Mr. A was inside, sweating it out. Okay? Inside the comfort room. When he returned, tapos na, nakapirma ng testator. So, that means the testator did not sign the will in the presence of Mr. A. If that fact can be established, that is not a valid will. The will be disallowed. If the will is disallowed, Mr. A will not get the legacy of 50 million. Siyempre, if the will is void, the legacies under that will are also void. Cannot be given effect. Eh, nandito si Mr. A. He has just taken the oath to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Eh, pero naalala niya, if the will is disallowed, hindi niya makukuha yung 50 million niya under the will. If we did not have Article 823, chances are, sasabihin ni A, I was right there in front of the testator when he was signing the will. Magsisinungaling yan. Let's be honest with each other. I do not think that there is any single soul in this room or in the other rooms watching my lecture who will not testify falsely under the same circumstances. 50 million yan ba? Aba ko naman. 50 million. Okay? Siyempre, sisinungaling ka na dyan. With Article 823, the law is in effect telling the witnesses, magsabi ka na ng totoo. Kasi hindi mo din naman makukuha yan eh. Okay? Might as well tell the truth. Because that legacy is void insofar as you are concerned. If there are three other witnesses aside from you, swerte ka. Okay? The will, the legacy will be valid. You'll be able to get it. Because the allowance of the will not really hinge upon you or depend upon you. There are three other competent witnesses. Supposing that instead of being given a legacy or device, one of the instrumental witnesses, one of the three, is instead instituted as an heir. Ang sabi ni X sa kanyang will, I give Mr. A 1/8 of my estate. A is one of the three witnesses. Will A be able to get 1/8 of the estate? I submit that he will not. Although the law mentions only legacy or device, there is really no reason why it should not likewise apply, why Article 823 should not likewise apply to a person who is instituted as an heir. There would just the same be the temptation to testify falsely because he would have an economic interest in the allowance of the will. Okay. The enumeration of the persons in Article 823 is exclusive. So, sino lang dyan? Yung witness, his spouse, his parent, or child. If instead his grandfather was the one given a legacy or device, that should be considered valid. Hanggang parent lang. Or hanggang child. Okay? Alright. Codicils and incorporation by reference. Tanda lang natin, ano yung codicil na yan? It is a supplement or addition to a will whereby the provisions in an earlier will are added to or modified, okay, or altered or explained. You only make a codicil if you already have a will. Okay? The execution of a codicil presupposes that there is a previously existing will, which you then supplement, alter, modify, or explain through your codicil. Okay. Formalities, same formalities as in the case of wills. You can therefore make either a notarial codicil or a holographic codicil. If the will which you want to alter, supplement, or modify is notarial, it does not necessarily follow that the codicil should also be notarial. A notarial will can be modified by a holographic codicil. And a holographic will can be altered, modified by notarial codicil. Okay? On incorporation by reference, ano itong incorporation by reference na ito? This is merely for the convenience of the testator. Lalo na yung sangkatutak ang mga pag-aari, sandamakmak ang pag-aari. Ha? If they have already existing lists of properties, descriptions of their properties or inventories, they don't have to actually reproduce these long lists and inventories in their last wills and testaments. They can simply incorporate them by reference under the provisions of Article 827.